How are we doing today? Welcome to my channel. Welcome back. Hope everybody's doing well, being safe. I am gearing up for camping season this year. I have a Whisper Light, MSR Whisper Light International multi-fuel stove. I got a propane Coleman dual burner stove, white fuel. But, you know, I used to have a MSR Whisper pocket rocket. I don't feel like paying $75 or whatever they are and $120 for a new updated Pro model and all that. Watching some video reviews, probably like you have, excuse me, on this Gas One backpacking stove. So it's only like 10 bucks off Amazon time of this video. Well, you can get cheaper if you want to wait longer to get it from China or wherever the hell they come from. Anyway, so I paid expedited shipping for basically overnight shipping. So the whole thing cost me with tax, title, overnight shipping, about 22 bucks. Why? Because I wanted it now. So I was going to buy the ISO fuel at Amazon as well, but found out Walmart has a better deal on the 16-ounce, well, this one's 15.5, fuel canisters. Walmart's the best place to get it. So anyways, let's open up the Gas One. Excuse me, part in the shadows here, trying to stay out of the direct sunlight. It's like 32 degrees and rising. Snow on the ground melting off. So anyways, let's get this opened up and let's take a look at this and we'll get it lighted up and try it out. Fortunately, I didn't bring a pot or anything to cook. Okay, so the lid comes off. Let me put that in my pockets. I don't lose it down in this old foundation hole. Looks like the stove is in there. Looks like you got to move the things around. So let me get out of there and we'll be right back. So that was simple enough. I just pull it out of the case, move one around towards the piezo part. And they all move, and the morning doves are up there above us. So let's flip these little pieces over. That gives us some stand. There you go. Whole thing probably feels like it weighs maybe 8 ounces. I don't know. I might be exaggerating, but feels very good quality. I don't think that's stainless steel. Just looks like a stamped metal of some sort, but... as long as it lasts, as long as it works. Anyways, let's get it fired up. Okay, so we got it fired, well, opened up. Got it installed. Oh, I can hear the gas. Let's see. Oh yeah, look at that. Whoa, that's warm, man. Oh yeah, look at that. I can bring that right down to a little simmer. You don't want it roaring. Not sure if it's as powerful of a unit BTUs as the pocket rocket, but there's the igniter. It says Gas One there. That piezo part, a little glow in there in the flames. Turn that up a little. Oh yeah, she's a roar, man. She's a copycat pocket rocket. I don't know if the camera shows the heat coming off that, but I can see it with the naked eye. Shut it off. No need to waste my fuel. Let's see what we got. We got a little burn. Huh. Let's try that again. Let it burn off any oils or any manufacturing stuff that may be on it. Got a little detent on that piezo button. It's not too bad, or up there. Ain't no way I'm getting my hand closer. I like making dehydrated meals in my food dehydrator. Putting them into food sealer bags or double Ziploc bag in it, bringing them camping and reconstitute it with a little bit of water. And I think this is the perfect ticket. Black cap chickie right down under tree branch. So checking us out, saying, "What are you doing, mister?" I don't know if the camera shows the heat just coming off of that. Be easy enough with some tinfoil to make a little windshield. Yeah, it sounds like the wind was just going to blow it out, but I got it turned down so it's not really high. Oh yeah, listen to that. Okay, let's shut off. Let's conserve fuel. Okay, that's already guess. Not bad. Not much more I can show you. It's burnt in. I'm gonna wait to cool things off before I put it back in its case, but basically that's the gas one. Isobutane camp stove. And I think it's gonna serve me well. And I'm sure it'll serve you well. Anyways, link will be in the product description below. Everybody be safe, tread lightly, have fun out there this summer, spring, fall, winter camping, whatever you're doing. Isobutane. I keep thinking propanol is good, but you need to keep these canisters warm. If you're in freezing conditions, they will freeze up. You will not get them to ignite, so I used to keep them in the center of a backpack. But this one's going to be in a survival bag or my camping bag in the back of the Jeep, so I don't think it'll ever freeze. If it does, just stick it in your armpit and around your belly, something. So anyways, we'll conclude here. Everybody have a great day. Me and Mojo are up here in Shrewsbury. We're heating up some water. And we're going to have this Marashushan? I don't even know how it's pronounced. Ramen noodle soup. Oh yeah. A little bit windy. I got to create a windshield for this damn thing. Maybe do a tinfoil or something. Doubled over tinfoil. My hot cocoa up here on the dash, gonna let it cool down for a minute. I'm gonna sit in the car and chow down my ramen noodles like Mojo's doing. I know, I'm sitting in the car. The wind is picking up out there. But anyways, I got a stick. I sharpened it to a flat point. That's my improvised spoon. So we're roughing it, kinda. Nope. Mike has got his spoon over there too.
Working a lot better. There.
Down to my broth. A little bit of noodles and veggies in there. Oh my god, being so cold out. Oh. I've never really liked soup broth before, but when it's cold like this, oh, it's worth $1 million, man. I'm back out to the car. Too warm in the Jeep. I got my cocoa. Skies are mostly clear. Sun's over that way. 28 degrees. At least in the Rutland, it was 28 degrees. I have no idea what it is here, but... Excuse me. Got the burps. Perfect day. I'm going to enjoy my cocoa later.